In this video, we're going to cover Inventor Chapter 2, Problem Number 3, the positioning stop. Now, in this video, I've already taken the liberty of setting up a couple of my guidelines to frame the base view to save time. And I've already indicated one big assumption. Looking at Problem Number 3, we could make the assumption that this is a symmetrical view. So some of these dimensions are duplicates and not necessary as soon as we put this note saying top front view symmetrical. Always take a look at your projective views and your base view. If all of them are symmetrical, put a note saying all views are symmetrical. If only one view is symmetrical, make sure you state which view is symmetrical. For this one, we have the top and the front view being symmetrical. The right view is not symmetrical, so that's why that one was left out. So I already set up my guidelines. The maximum dimensions, the largest dimensions that I have, are 4 and 2.5. So this is already preset to 4 inches away and 2.5 inches. Okay, so that is set. Now the next dimension that I'm gonna put is the legs on the left and the right of this drawing, which happens to be 1.75 up. So, use my triangle here and measure 1.75, which, if you do the quick math, should be 1 3/4. So we have 1 4/8 5/8 6/8, and we have it over here. And if I measure correctly, when I use my t-square and my triangle, they should line up. So 1/2 5/8 6/8. Again, the ruler that I'm using on this triangle happens to be divided in eighths, so I always count that way. Okay, I could always use this ruler as well in sixteenths. It'll give me the same measurements. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and line that up, and they line up pretty close. So mark there, mark there. I'm gonna draw a line right down the center at 2.0 so I can find the center of this. Again, I'm gonna project this line out. I could definitely use it later, especially when I am dimensioning. And let me go ahead and put the center mark of this shape, which happens to be 1 1/4. Okay. Now for this model, I don't need to do any scaling. Everything's 1 for 1, so I am not doing any division here. So we have 1 1/4. So 1 1/8 2/8 1/4. Double check it over here to make sure I have a nice square drawing. 1 1/4. And let's go ahead and put that right there. And let's have that crosshair right there. Okay. So let's go back to our drawing. So next couple measurements. Let's go ahead and take care of these diagonals. I know that the distance from here to here will be 4 minus 1.25. I believe that's 1 3/8. So, going back to this, measure 1 1/8 2/8 3/8. And 1 1/8 1 and 1 8 2 8 3 8. Now, if I did everything correctly, the center should be 1 1/4. And when I check it, 1 1/4, pretty close. Okay, so let's go ahead and connect those diagonals. here. All right. So I'm going to go ahead and frame this up. Like I mentioned before in other videos, I like to kind of offset my measurements so my pencil has somewhere to travel. And all this is made possible and easy when I square the paper and I just slide everything off the T-square. Okay. Looking good. All right. I'll go ahead and add my circle dimensions. But it looks like I'm missing two, so let's go back to this for reference. So I have the crosshair for my big circle, and I need the crosshairs for my two smaller circles. And they're both 0.75 away from each edge, so I'll just go ahead and measure 0.75 from here and just draw that line across. 1/2. 5/8, 6/8. And let's go ahead and double check over here. 4/8, 5/8, 6/8, 3/4. And we have 5/6. Go ahead and draw that. Draw that. And we're going ahead and draw that pretty close. Okay. And I'm going to extend these out just a bit for my crosshairs. All right, so let's go ahead and take care of the circles. So I have my center circle that is diameter 1 1/4. So I have 1 1/4 right here. Try to line it up the best I can. Looks pretty good there. Make sure nothing is obstructing. And that looks good, so go ahead and draw that circle. Okay, and we have 3/4. So we have that one right there. And we have that one right there. Now you can always test it. A little bit of a flat circle there. You can always test it with your triangle and square. If everything was drawn correctly, there should be some tangency here. And that is pretty close right there. So crosshairs definitely worked. So I'm just going to project these lines up now. So I can use them later for my other views. Tangency. Trust me guys, just keep at it and you will get better at this. Become second nature and the next set of drawings should be easier. Go redo that one. Make sure that's nice and flat. Pretty good. Okay, so You could definitely focus on the right or top view. And just for the sake of complication, let's go ahead and focus on the top view. All right, so again, I'm gonna look at this. I'm gonna try to visualize where we're gonna be adding these dimensions. So I'm gonna pick some point right here for the view. So let's go ahead and pick that line right there. So that's gonna be my top. And going back from the drawing, I know the thickness is going to be a quarter. So, measure quarter. Make sure this is nice and flat. And go back and darken these lines. All right, looks good. And let's go ahead and project some of these other lines. So this edge should be here. And that edge should be there. And because I have to show this is a through hole, let's go ahead and add these center line bisectors. So I have dot, dot, line, dot, dot, line, dot, dot, line. Dot, dot, line, dot, dot, line. And let's go ahead and add these hidden lines. This one happens to share the same edge, so that one's fine. Dot, 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 dot. So all my lines are there. So that was fairly easy. So now we're going to focus on the right-hand view. And again, some point that is pretty good. So let's go ahead and pick that right there. And it's the same thickness, which happens to be a quarter. 1/8 quarter. Move it over so my pencil can draw. Okay. Now, if you guys are getting any smudging, it's always a good idea to check your tools. Make sure there's no extra graphite on the bottom. If you do, just take it to the sink, clean it up. Dry it off, it should be fine. All right, so I have that. So let's go ahead and transfer some other lines. So that edge I could definitely see. And this will share the hidden line. And we're going to show that hidden line. Yeah, that hidden line, sure, that top line, but I should be still able to see some of these lines kind of get overwritten. So that one definitely still get. And let's go ahead and look at right there. Okay, so all my hidden lines are transferred. Now, you may ask yourself, Mr. Rosso, shouldn't I add the centerline bisector there? No, because of so many holes there and you really don't know where they are. you try to add centerline bisector in the view that is the clearest. So I'm going to leave those intact. All right, so the drawing is pretty much done. Then from here, you're going to go back and reuse some of these lines for dimensioning. Now, just like in Inventor, you're trying to spread out these dimensions. So let's go ahead and transfer some of these dimensions. So for this top view and this right view, I'll probably add the length and the height. So from over here, I'm going to extend this line out. Make two lines here, one line there. And I'm going to project this line. One line there. Okay, and I'm just going to go ahead and add those dimensions. So, just like before, arrow, 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 arrow. Back and darken them. Just leave a little space there for my dimensioning later. Okay, and we have 1.75, and we have, excuse me, that is the wrong dimension. That should be the major dimension, which is supposed to be 2.5, so. And we have 1.75 over here. All right, so took care of those. So on my top view, let's go with length. And let's go ahead and draw dimensions and bring them down this way. So I'm going to put the 4.0, and I'm going to put this dimension here, which happens to be 1.25. So let's go ahead and select somewhere here. And somewhere about halfway there. So go ahead and put that arrow. And we're going to go ahead and put that arrow there. And I'm going to darken it, leave the center open, darken it, leave the center open, and that should be 4.0. Let's go ahead and add some dimensions there, leave that center open, and that should be 1.25. Okay, so that's good. So out of the 10 dimensions that I need, 1, 2, 3, 4, I need 6 more. All right, so that's taken care of. Let's go ahead and focus on the dimensions of the circle. So I'll probably put the 0.75 here on this side, and I'll also put maybe one dimension from the 1.25 over here. So go ahead and project this view over here. And we have, let's go ahead and project that down over here. All right, so some point right there that looks pretty good. Draw a line there, and let's go ahead and draw a line right there. So, draw that arrow, draw that arrow. You know that that is 0.75, and you know that this is 0.75. Draw the arrow, draw the arrow. Go back in and darken it. good. Now I have plenty of space on the left, so let's go ahead and project this line a little bit further out. And let's go and drop that line down there. And I'll put the 1.25 right there, the height of the center circle, which is 1.25. And I'm going to darken the arrow. And I'm going to go ahead and reuse this bottom line. Or I could bring it up over here. Let's put it over here, kind of clean that up. So draw a line somewhere around there. Draw a line there, arrow, somewhere in the center. That should be 2.0. So let's go ahead and put 2.0. Draw a line there, draw a line there. Let's do a quick inventory. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I need two more dimensions. And those two last dimensions that we're gonna need are just gonna be the diameters of the circle. So I am going ahead and do some of these lines here. So I'm gonna draw an arrow going down here. And I'm going to line it up with this other projection line that I had before. So we have that. Draw an arrow there. We have diameter 0.5. And I'll probably draw an arrow from here to here, a nice, even, clean space. Try to spread out my dimensions here. Dimension going that way. I guess I'll use this line here and clean that up. And that should be... Go back and clean this up before I forget. Okay, that should be theta 1.25. Draw an arrow right there. And all my dimensioning is done, so all I gotta do is go back and clean this up. And problem number three is done. I just gotta add my crosshairs before I forget anything here. And those can be quickly taken care of. I hope this video has been helpful. Again, guys, I know this is difficult. Don't give up. You could definitely do this. It does take some practice, but you guys can get there, okay? Now, we could definitely make arrangements where students can check these tools out and take them home for the weekend. All I would need is your student ID. Now, if you want to have your own set, you're more than welcome to buy your own. They do sell them at Michael's, and they do sell them in the store in Walnut called Carpe Diem. I've seen these sets online on Amazon and eBay. It just depends what you want to do, guys. But again, you definitely always will have the tools here in the lab. So I hope this video helped. Make sure you go back and clean up your drawings. Make sure you add all the vital information, scale, name, date, the name of the drawing. Good job, Raiders. Keep it up. We'll see you in class.